Sean Hatzel here with Getling and 12. If you're watching the last one, I apologize. I had a new microphone. I'm outside here in sunny Florida and it was crackling the entire time and it ruined the video. So my apologies. Let's try this again. If you're scrolling through your feed, stop by and say hi. Post your where you're from in the comment section and pay close attention, especially if you're over 35 years old, because I'm going to share three exercises people over 35 should avoid. And they're very popular exercises, as you'll see right here. Plus, I'm going to share the 12-minute protocol that helps people in their 40s, 50s, and 60s optimize hormones to quickly lose belly fat. So before I get into details about the three exercises that you should avoid, and I introduce you to this 12-minute protocol, it's found inside the system at the link that you'll find somewhere around this video. It's called the Over 40 Absolution. And the reason that I created the Over 40 Absolution is twofold. One, when I was just 28 years old, I entered the Body for Life contest, which is the world's largest body transformation contest put on by Bill Phillips. And I was fortunate enough to be second place out of over 22,000 finishers, and that was my catalyst into the fitness industry. Now I'm a 46-year-old grandfather. I've reached and helped over 100,000 people across the globe online in the last 5 years. Well, what happened is during that contest, I took my body fat from 20% all the way down to 5%, and at the same time, I gained 5 pounds of muscle. And I did it using interval training, high-intensity weight training, and a sound diet. But as I got older, and now that I'm in my 40s, the hormonal differences make a huge impact on the type of exercise that you do. So most of today's most popular exercises are mostly designed for younger people, and I'll share more about that in a second. Now, when you click the link somewhere around this video, you'll also go to the website where you'll learn the story about my 57-year-old wife, Karen. That's the second reason I created this system. When we met over 14 years ago, a couple years after we met, she was diagnosed with colorectal cancer, and this forced her into early menopause. And so she accumulated a ton of upper belly fat. And this 12-minute protocol found inside the Over 40 Absolution system is what helped her flatten her belly. And you'll see her after pictures when you go over to our website. Now, there's one more promise I want to make before I dive into this. And that is that this isn't just about achieving a leaner, healthier body for people in their 40s, 50s, or 60s. This isn't about just optimizing hormones for people in their 40s, 50s, and 60s. This is about a better quality of life. See, one thing that I've learned over the last 20 years of being in this industry is that when you focus 5% of your time, and after all, this is only going to take you 12 minutes about 4 or 5 times in the week. And when you focus just 5% of your time weekly on exercise and sound nutrition that I share inside my system, I have a guide in there called the Lean 19. It's 19 diet tips that are specifically designed for the hormonal condition of people over 35 years old. And when you apply yourself consistently with this, I promise you that it will leak over into every other area of your life in a positive way. My wife Karen and I know that when we focus on this stuff, we're better parents, we're better grandparents, we're better at our careers, we're more focused and driven, we're happier, we're healthier, and you get all these bonus side effects simply by investing 12 minutes a day. So let's talk about the first exercise you should avoid if you're over 35 years old. The first one is crunches and sit-ups. And the reason you should avoid crunches and sit-ups is threefold. Number one, spot reduction is a myth in the stomach. Most people do crunches and sit-ups thinking that they're going to get a flatter belly, when in reality, all you're really doing is working a muscle that's underneath the fat that needs to be burned off. So instead, you should be engaging in activities that help you burn belly fat. And truth be told, if you sit here and you do relentless crunches and sit-ups and you build up that muscle, and you don't lose the belly fat, you could actually make your stomach stick out even further. The second reason is herniated disc risk. Stuart McGill is one of the world's most renowned back experts. And his research shows that crunches and sit-ups are one of the leading causes of herniated discs. So if you ever go to the gym or your health club and you see these people crunching away trying to lose their belly, not only are they building up their stomach muscles underneath the fat that they want to burn off, they could be damaging their back. And the final reason is Men's Health posted an article, and it talked about how it takes 22,000 crunches just to burn one measly pound of belly fat. I mean, your time could be spent much better doing the 12-minute protocol found inside the Over 40 Absolution. The second exercise that you want to avoid if you're over 35 years old is the DVD workouts that are so popular these days. So DVD workouts like P90X, Insanity, and CrossFit, these are amazing workouts. They work. Look at the infomercials. Look at the testimonials. But they're designed for younger people. You see, when you're in your 40s and 50s or 60s, you must move differently than younger people if you want to optimize hormones and quickly lose belly fat. So not only are they designed for younger people, they take 60 to 90 minutes. I don't know about you, but I don't have 60 to 90 minutes, 5 days a week to work out. I want to have a life. I want to get it done in 12 minutes and be done. Best of all, when you use this 12-minute protocol, you can actually elevate your metabolic rate for up to 38 to 48 hours afterwards. And again, you'll see the research and the studies at the link somewhere around this video confirming that this is substantiated and it's published in scientific journals. Also, these ballistic movements can be very hard on your joints. So you want to use movement patterns, rest periods, and intensity levels that are designed for your current hormonal condition. That's why I created the Over 40 App Solution. The third exercise that you want to avoid is cardio. Now listen, I'm not here to bash cardio. I'm not saying that cardio doesn't work to help you lose belly fat, but most people abuse it. There is a specific time that you should do steady state cardio a couple times a week, and I share this specific time with you inside my system. But there are four published studies that I'll post above this video showing that too much cardio done in excessive amounts suppresses the thyroid gland. The thyroid regulates your metabolism. If you hear the wind out here, I apologize. I'm down here in Florida and I'm outside. So the first thing it does is it suppresses your body's ability to convert T4 to T3. The second thing is it increases cortisol levels inside the body. Cortisol is known as a stress hormone. The third study shows that it increases cravings and hunger. This particular study showed that people who do too much cardio eat 100 more calories after they're done than they just burned off, which means it makes it impossible to keep the body in a calorie deficit to burn belly fat. And the last study shows that it raises levels of free radicals. Free radicals are linked to accelerated aging and many of today's most modern health challenges. So, if you got something out of this video so far, do me a favor, click the like button and share it. Let's spread the word. And before you click the link somewhere on this video, I want to talk about a couple more things that are near and dear to my heart that I'm really passionate about. The first thing is that for every person who grabs a copy of the Over 40 App Solution, we donate 90 days of clean water to a needy child in a third world country. And we're so passionate about our partnership with Living Water International that we've actually went to Nicaragua the last 3 years for a week to help install water wells. Last year alone, my company, Gentlean and 12, was fortunate and blessed enough to give $30,000 to Living Water International. Because of people like you who grabbed a copy of our system, we installed 4 water wells across the globe to help needy children. One was done in Zimbabwe, where they had a medical clinic that they couldn't open because people were sick from the contaminated water, so they couldn't open the medical clinic. So as soon as the well was installed, sponsored by Gentlean and 12, thanks to folks like you who take action and grab a copy, now they opened up the medical clinic and they could treat all these sick people. Pretty cool stuff. I also wrote down a couple things right here I just want to quickly share with you, because when you go over to our website, you're going to see a bunch of guides. So I don't want you to feel overwhelmed. I want you to start with the success tracker, because it's going to give you the workout charts and it's going to give you the diet tips that you need to follow with these workout charts. And it's condensed into just like a 14-page manual. Now, you will have a 90-page manual that you can read as well, but I recommend you just start with the success tracker because more is not better. We want to keep things simple. That's the problem with weight loss. It's confusing. So I'm going to simplify your fat loss. The other thing you're going to discover is timing, the right combinations, and the right portion control of the foods that you eat. This will allow the body to stay in a fat-burning environment. For example, did you know that if you like to eat your favorite cheat foods a couple times a week, that you can do it and still potentially avoid fat spillover if you do it after the 12-minute protocol found inside my system? What else do I want to talk about here? Yeah, so there's the Lean 19 diet tips. So there's 19 diet tips for people over 40. And the last thing that I want to talk about is combinations of food. So if you like carbohydrates, they don't necessarily make you fat. You just have to know how to eat them the right way. So you want to eat them after exercise, because then they'll be stored inside muscle tissue and liver tissue that's just been depleted from the 12-minute protocol that you performed. You also want to combine them with protein. This will help stabilize insulin to keep the body in a fat-burning environment. And then you want to avoid excessive amounts of fat when you eat carbs. When you eat carbs, they'll typically spike your insulin higher and faster than other foods. And if a lot of fat is present in the bloodstream at the same time, that insulin is a storage hormone, so it could potentially take that fat and store it. So the solution is to keep your fat intake under 15 grams when you eat carbs, then of course include a protein in that meal to stabilize the insulin levels. So again, if you got something out of this and you learned something, make sure you share it, make sure you like it, drop a comment, let us know where you're from. If you have questions, we'll do our best to answer them. And everything that I've talked about inside this video, research-wise, all the studies will be posted just above this video for all you science geeks out there. So thanks for watching this and keep going strong.